Well, I think there are a lot of threats emanating from the Muslim world, from radicals and some who are not necessarily committed to terrorism, but whose policies threaten Western civilization. And I think in many respects they threaten moderate Islam. So it's a complicated subject, but one that should be at the top of our political agenda in an election year, should be at the top of our agenda regardless. And I think this conference has been a fantastic idea. So important to keep this debate going because many in the mainstream media don't want it to happen.
Tell us a little bit about Muslim reform. You mentioned that it's an issue as well, reforming Islam.
Well, you know, King Abdullah of Jordan has called the radical threat a civil war within Islam. And he's not just the Muslim king of a Muslim country, but the descendant of the Sharifs of the Hejaz, so he knows what he's speaking about. And when you see Muslim political leaders like General al-Sisi in Egypt, who's a marked man from the Muslim Brotherhood and others, trying to help encourage Islamic intellectuals and scholars to address this question, it shows there are real signs of hope. But the West has to stand with those who appreciate the threat that radical Islam poses. And since it poses a threat to Muslims all over the world, as well as the West, we have a lot that we can join forces on.
So what exactly do you think we can do to help that effort?
Well, I think the first thing we have to do is recognize this is an ideological threat. This is not a question about religion. This is a question about a politicized version. That's what Abdullah means when he talks about a civil war for control of what the central tenets of Islam are going to be. And so in this country, when we have people who think there's not a war that the terrorists are waging against us, they think it's a law enforcement matter, obviously people are not going to understand it. So I think understanding the nature of the threat is the most important thing, and then how to deal with it and its various manifestations. I think it's important to understand this is not just a Sunni radical problem. I look at the Islamic Revolution in Iran, in control since 1979, as the principal threat of radical Islam. It's the central banker of international terrorism. It's on a path to nuclear weapons. So there are multiple threats from multiple sources, and we need to understand all of them so that we can have really a global strategy to deal with it.
So it's global, it's national. There's what about the Iran deal?
Well, this is the worst debacle in American diplomatic history. There's simply nothing good you can say about it. And as more and more comes out about the terms of not just the nuclear deal, but as we've just seen, cash for hostages and many other aspects of the deal, it just gets worse and worse and worse. The central problem, of course, is that it puts the Ayatollahs on a basically unimpeded path toward nuclear weapons at a time of their choosing, and that's extraordinarily dangerous for the United States, for our friends around the world, and for the prospects of containing or defeating, ultimately, radical Islam itself.
And we're funding it.
Well, we are. I mean, this the unfreezing of over $100 billion of frozen assets, the relief of international sanctions, which especially benefits the Europeans, the amount of wealth we have given the Ayatollahs access to is incalculable. And of course, it will be used for many things, but in particular to fund terrorist activities for their ballistic and nuclear weapons programs. It's just an extraordinary act of surrender on the part of the United States for no reason.
Under President Trump, how do you see foreign policy changing?
Well, I think he has delineated a very clear path to defeat radical Islam before it inflicts any more damage on us. I think as a political matter, the debate is about as clear as it can be. I just hope people will have a chance to hear it and consider what the alternatives are. Which the media will do their best to avoid. It may be that it's going to be the debates this fall that highlight the differences most importantly, so I hope people tune in.